I don't think it's a mistake if you're watching it and you watch this to the end. You're probably feeling overwhelmed. You're probably feeling the way that I was feeling. You're maybe pacifying hard things in your life with shopping. Hey friends, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Kate. I would love to have you subscribe, join the community. There's an awesome community of mamas here. So please join us. I would love that so much. And let's get started. About family and minimalism, or specifically your family and minimalism. I get really excited about talking about minimalism because it's kind of a journey I embarked on about 15 months ago, and it's really changed my life for the better in so many ways. So I really want to share that with other moms. I know it's a message that can change a lot of households, a lot of families, just because of the freedom that it gives you. And yeah, I'm not saying my house is perfectly, immaculately clean all of the time, but it certainly is better than it used to be. It truly is. It's given my life so much freedom because I'm just not constantly cleaning up. And anyways, I'm sure you've heard me talk about that a little bit before if you've been here for a while, but I just wanted to talk to you today about kind of getting started when minimalism feels overwhelming with a family, especially and specifically with young kids. I know when I first heard the idea of minimalism, I was like, yeah, sure, single people, great. Not with a family, not with young kids. Like, that's just impossible. If it was just me, I'd be like, hey, yeah, no problem. I'll sell all my stuff, throw it in a backpack and travel the world. Like, that's kind of what I thought of minimalism. But, you know, I couldn't travel the world and throw all my belongings in a backpack because I have three young kids. Kids that love toys, kids that don't value clean space over fun and chaos and all their toys on the ground. Kids who leave behind so much laundry and so many dishes and all the crumbs. Oh, and don't forget all those crafts and creations and glue and stickers and paper all just jumbled together. So through this 15-month journey, I have gotten rid of a ton of things. And at first, my kids were not on board at all. There was a lot of, you know, I really involved them in the beginning, but now I kind of have taken things into my own hands because I know what they do and don't play with. So the last time I decluttered, I did not involve them with the toys and I removed some things that I never see them play with. And you know what? They haven't even noticed that they're gone. But anyways, now I hear my kids saying stuff like, oh, mom, I want to donate this, or mom, we don't need that. That is not something that I'm like teaching them to say. That's just something they're picking up by me leading as an example and being a role model for them. I get questions all the time, like, I don't really know where to start with this. And I'm not saying I am a perfect minimalist. I still have a long ways to go. I still have more I want to get rid of. And for me, it's a journey. It's an evolving journey that I just keep gaining more freedom and getting rid of more stuff and gaining more freedom and getting rid of more stuff. But people ask me, where did you start? Like, what kind of changed this for you? And for me, it was just a constant feel of overwhelm and feeling like I was drowning in stuff and feeling like I was constantly cleaning and constantly like nagging at my kids to pick up their room and clean up their room and not having time to just sit down and play with them, or not having the time I wanted to put into my blog, or not having the time I wanted to go on date nights because my house was a mess and I was like embarrassed to have a babysitter over and I didn't want to spend the whole day making sure it was clean just so I could go out on a date night. Do you see where I'm going with this? Like, it was just a lot of overwhelm, and I think we managed fine for a long time, but now, 15 months later, I just see like life can be so much better, and I don't know why I held on to so much stuff for so long. And I know a lot of it was emotional. I've shared before in the past how I used retail therapy as a way to cope with emotions and foster parenting, but that really wasn't getting to the issue. You know, back then I wasn't reading my Bible daily. I wasn't in the Word. I wasn't, you know, feeding myself spiritually. I wasn't taking care of myself. I was staying up far too late. I was eating junky food. You know, I just, it sounds kind of silly, but it's not. Like, just removing stuff has allowed me to really focus and excel in a lot of other areas in my life, if that makes sense. So where you want to start is just start spending twice as much time as money that you do on your kids. So that means stop buying toys. They don't need to be entertained with a movie or, you know, an amusement park or something every single weekend. You don't need to be constantly filling their calendar with sports. Like, get back to the basics a little bit. Get down on the floor and play with them. You know, there's lots of simple things, simple pleasures in life that we tend to bombard our kids with so much excess and so much stuff that they can't even enjoy the simple things. But when you start removing all that excess, you can see how much fun you can have as a family with like a simple game night, or, you know, going to the park, walking down by the river and throwing rocks in. Like, kids love this stuff. It doesn't cost anything, and you're able to really bond as a family than, you know, sitting beside each other in a movie theater or buying them toys that they're just gonna throw into the shelf next week kind of thing. You know what I mean? Like, it's really cultivating a relationship with your kids, and minimalism has been able to do that for us, and I just love it. So if you want to implement minimalism as a family, you have to realize it starts with you. Stop using your kids as an excuse. I did that for a long time. Don't use your husband as an excuse, like he likes stuff and he's not going to want to live this way. Just simply start with your stuff. Start with your clothes, your knickknacks, pictures, hobbies that you maybe don't do anymore, a candle obsession you may have, whatever it may be. Start with you and just be a role model for the rest of the family. I promise that's how I started, and 15 months later, it's been life-changing for my whole family. And like I said earlier, my kids are like wanting to donate and saying, like thinking about who can we give this to? Who would be able to play with this? Because we don't play with this anymore. So stop using your kids and your husband as a barrier. There's so much freedom on the other side once you free yourself of excess and clutter. You know, families, after all, are the ones who benefit from minimalism the most because of the way it can change relationships and change the time spent. Dare I say, families can benefit from minimalism way more than a couple or a single person could. I think we all can, but I think families definitely benefit the most. I used the fact that I had young kids as an excuse for way too long. When I realized, you know what, it starts with me, that's when things really began to change. And I just went room by room, and then I did another round of room by room. And each time I go room by room, I'm able to free up more things, and I want to get rid of more things. And it's funny because my eye is almost trained to like hate clutter. When I see something that before I wouldn't have thought was cluttered at all, now I'm kind of like, ooh, like what else can I get rid of? Have I really used this? Have I really worn this shirt? I love when my closet looks a lot more bare. You know, before I had so much stuff, I never wore half of it because I just didn't even know what I had. And now I know exactly what I have. All the pieces I have, I love. So just go room by room. Just get started. Start with you, go room by room, and the freedom comes. As you do each round of those rooms, the freedom comes, and the ability to let go becomes a lot easier. And you're gonna see like these little time pockets start. I've been blogging for over 3 years now, but I've really been able to get serious about it in the last year. And I have big dreams and big goals for this blog, be able to travel with my family and be like location independent. I have a lot of dreams and goals with this, but I never had the time because I was constantly tackling the laundry mountain or the dirty dishes in the sink or whatever it may be. Now that I've removed so much stuff from my home, I just have extra time to do the things I love. Like, this is a passion project. I love connecting with you guys. I love talking about foster care and being an advocate for foster care. I love blogging. I love the creativity. I love making videos and editing videos, but it is a lot of time. So I just, you know, my blog really suffered because I couldn't do it well. I didn't have the time. And just in the last year, year and a half, I've been able to commit a lot more time to it. And that is all to minimalism. And I mean, I also have 2 daycare days a week now, so that's really helping as well. But I contribute that all to minimalism. I have more time to play with my kids when they get home from school. Just sit down and play with them or read a book or whatever it may be. Because I'm not, oh, I got the dishes to do, I gotta get to, like, I'm just much more organized. My headspace is much clearer. So my kids are seeing that benefit in me. They're seeing that their mom is playing with them more, is doing things with them more, where I'm not nagging them to just clean their room, pick up your toys. Instead of nagging, I just decided to model it. And my kids are really seeing that now. Minimalism does not mean getting rid of everything. Like, keep what's important to you. I suggest writing down, like sitting down as a family and writing down a list of things that are important to you. What do you value as a family? Is that dinners together every night at the table? Is that being able to go on vacation? Is that being able to be hospitable and have other families in? You know, what is important to you? What are your goals as a family? And then kind of look at all your stuff, and whatever doesn't align with those goals, get rid of it. If you have too much stuff that you're like embarrassed to have people in to be hospitable, start getting rid of stuff, because I feel a lot more in control of my space and my stuff and whatnot. I feel the ability to be more hospitable because I'm not just constantly overwhelmed with cleaning. So, you know, what's important to you, write that all down, and then look at the stuff, and whatever doesn't align with what's important to you, I suggest getting rid of it. And that's a great way to start. And while you're doing this, also remember, just spend less money on your kids and spend more time on them. Get on the ground, build forts, play with them, have game nights. You know, we've implemented like a weekly game night, which was something we never used to do because I was never in the place where I had enough organization and structure in my schedule, because I was always behind on something, like just constantly felt behind, like I was dropping the balls. I couldn't get on top of the laundry. I couldn't get on top of the dishes. The floors needed to be washed. Oh, the bathrooms need to be done again already. Didn't I just, like, my mind was just so cluttered because my external space was so cluttered. Reassess your traditions. For us, like Easter and Valentine's Day used to come with a basket full of stuff, little trinkets and junk, stuff from the dollar store. We've just changed how we do traditions now. Instead of this basket full of stuff that they're not going to use in a week, and, you know, that's going to go in a bucket for the rest of the year till the holiday comes around the next year, we still have a couple things like that. Like, they still have an Easter basket that I keep for them every year. Just minimizing all of the excess of it. So now they get a consumable item, a treat that they can have. And also, if they, like, for Easter, I always used to get them outfits. If they haven't grown and they don't really need a nice, like, Sunday best outfit, then I don't bother. I haven't gotten them anything. I didn't get them anything last year, and I'm not getting them anything this year either. But before, it used to be, you know, because of the tradition of how I grew up, it was an Easter outfit and chocolates and a new basket and bubbles and chalk and da da. And yes, if the kids need that stuff to play with in the summer, then I will get it for them. But we still have tons from 2 Easters ago. So every year I would just keep buying more and more and more. And now I have like a bucket full of, you know, I'm stocked with bubbles and sidewalk chalk. So I don't need to get that for them this year, just because it's tradition. So Christmas is another big one. I used to go so overboard with presents. That's how my family did it for me. So it's just, you know, what I did for my kids. What is important to us about the traditions is the religious meaning behind it, and that we're celebrating Christ's death, we're celebrating Christ's birth. So this year my kids got like 4 or 5 gifts, and a Bible was one of them, and they were more like higher quality intentional gifts that they needed. Like, we were going on a trip right after Christmas, so they got travel pillows with their Bible, and then like a little toy they could bring on the plane, where before it would just be like, how many things can I wrap for my kids to open so they're excited, like things like that. So just keep in mind how you do traditions and how can you maybe do them a little bit differently so you're not bringing more excess into your home. The paper clutter. So I'm not gonna lie to you guys. Paper is my biggest downfall. Not so much with the kids. I'm pretty ruthless with the kids' stuff coming in. I'm always worried I'm gonna throw out something important or whatnot. I feel like mentally I'm there, but I've still just been kind of throwing clutter into a box. I like to have it all in one space, but it's not specifically organized. So that's probably a video I'm gonna do for you guys in the next few weeks, because I really just want to get rid of a bunch, shred a bunch of stuff that we don't need to keep anymore, and just really try to minimize that as well. But I have a couple like just ongoing boxes of stuff that need to be filed properly I haven't done. And kids' stuff that, you know, sometimes it gets put on the fridge or put in their room or put in our room in my mail folder. Like, there's little things. So this is my weakest area. It's something that I am actively working on. I have new systems in place, like bringing stuff into my home. I have like a 5 divider little folder thing. So I have bills that need to be paid, things that need to be filed, schoolwork, stuff that my husband needs to look at. And every week I go through that and then I put it in the appropriate place. Like, going forth now, I have a system in place. The kids' schoolwork goes on the fridge for a couple days and then it goes. If it's a big thing, I'll take a picture of it and store it in their like school digital file. Or if it's something really special, I will keep it. But each have a small file folder that needs to be fully organized better, but I'm just going to do each grade of it. So, you know, it's like this thick. It's not going to be any bigger than that. And that's going to keep all of their schoolwork, important documents, crafts, report cards. And I'm going to do it by grade, because to me, that's the way my brain works. If you guys haven't ever seen Clutterbug on here on YouTube, she's awesome because she has a system, like we all organize a little bit differently. And some people are visual and some people just need to know that it's in a safe spot. Some people are really like, you know, it has to be just so right from day one. So there's 4 different kinds of bugs. I don't really remember what I am. You know, I keep it all in one safe spot, but it's not necessarily itemized and organized right from the beginning. I love when things are itemized and organized right from the beginning. And now that I've gotten rid of excess, I'm able to do that a lot easier. But, you know, previously my like go-to is just throw it all in this box. I know that if I'm looking for it, it will at least be in this box. Where now I'm kind of trying to switch to the other way. So, you know, find out what works best for you. There's different organization systems that are going to work better for different people. So, like I said, this is not my strongest suit. I definitely recommend you check out Clutterbug and her little bug types. And she's got a ton of great organizational and house cleaning videos on her channel that just help you figure out what kind of organizer and cleaner you are, and, you know, how to work, how to create systems within that. For me, I have systems that work and I like to share them with you guys, like my responsibility chart system. I have a cleaning system that's in my content library. These work for me, but I don't think they will work for everybody. So if you find maybe traditional things or things that you have tried before haven't worked, I definitely recommend checking out Clutterbug. And the last little tip I want to get for starting with minimalism is do challenges. We do challenges with our kids all the time, whether it's like, let's see how many things we can pick up in 5 minutes or 15 minutes, and we'll set a timer and make it a fun party and we're picking everything up together and like the house is clean in no time. Or we'll do challenges like, how many stuffed animals do you think we can give away this Christmas? I want 3 on your bed and all of the rest have to fit in this box. So how many do you think we can give away? And make it a challenge and make it exciting like that. So even though they're parting with things that they love dearly, you put into their mind like it's going to somebody good and somebody who really needs it. And you only need 3 on your bed and you can have this one bin full of stuffed animals. For us at the house full of girls, the stuffed animals take over quickly. People are constantly giving us gifts of stuffed animals, but they have a few that they love and they cherish, and that's great. I actually just got rid of it, but I had a stuffed animal until my last time I decluttered my kids' room that I couldn't let go of. It was the special bear. And you know what? I finally got rid of it after 32 years. So I'm trying to instill them in a younger age that, yes, they're special stuffed animals, but tons of stuffed animals come into the home. So they all need to fit in this one 12 by 12 little storage box we have that goes in their room on a shelf, and then they can have 3 on the bed. And everything else is like, how many can we give? And make it exciting like that. Kids love challenges. You know, most kids have a competitive bone in them, some not at all, but especially if your kid does, try challenges and try different things like that. Anyways, I hope you find this video helpful. I don't think it's a mistake if you're watching it and you watch this to the end. You're probably feeling overwhelmed. You're probably feeling the way that I was feeling. You're maybe pacifying hard things in your life with shopping. You're maybe searching for something to fill you, and that's with consumerism, but that's not actually filling you, so you keep bringing more and more in, and now you just feel overwhelmed. If that's you, please check out some of my other content. I don't have a ton on minimalism, but the Minimal Mom here on YouTube, Dawn, she's awesome. She has a lot of great systems to put into place. I want to bring more minimalism content, but I'm still very much in the journey. I am by no means an expert. So I'm just trying to share with you what I've experienced as I've gone through this journey in the past 15 months. And, you know, I hope to share more with you and consider myself not an expert, but just more experienced in that area, because I know how it changed my motherhood. I know the ability of the impact that it can have on your family. So anyways, I hope some of these tips were helpful. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with someone that might find it helpful. Subscribe if you're new, I'd love to have you, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye.